another vlog. Starting this one today. It is Thursday. We're in the middle of packing for our trip. We're heading out to Mexico, specifically this area called Merida. I guess it's in Yucatan. I've never been, ever, but I've been told it's very close to Tulum. So we'll see if that's true. We're heading out there for my cousin's wedding, and I'm a bridesmaid, so I literally have so much left to pack. We've done zero damage, and this is me trying to prepare for this weather because it's been so stinking cold here. Raining every day, but there it's like rain as well, just super hot. So yeah, that'll be interesting. But yeah, I just wanted to hop on here, basically say hi. Welcome back to another vlog. My name is Carolyn, but everyone basically calls me Carol. So I might just start introing my videos with Carol instead of Carolyn, because it just sounds weird to say it like that now. Anyhow, I wanted to start off the vlog here because we're packing and basically this is the beginning of the trip. So I'm gonna take you guys along with us. I told myself this is literally only 3 days we're there. It's a very casual setting outside of the wedding itself. And like for that, I have a dress. So I really shouldn't have a huge problem packing. I think I just overthink what I may or may not need. And so like in typical female fashion, I overdo it. Yeah, I'm just sipping on my greens. Trying to get these in before I really have anything to eat. We went to a workout class this morning and Chick-fil-A was on the way here, so we got some chicken minis. I'm also on the gut reset right now again, so I'm trying my best to stick to it as best as possible, but honestly, this week has just been so fast-paced. I've had so much homework to get in before we leave, and I apologize for my hair being a mess. I'm just trying to let it air dry. I just took out my towel. I need to comb it and put my hair gel stuff in it just so it kind of stays tamed. But anyhow, I'm gonna be packing, and yeah, I was trying to get all my homework assignments and stuff done before we leave, but it's not looking like that's gonna be able to happen. I was only able to finish one. Luckily the other one is like very small and brief, but I'm probably gonna be taking my laptop and working on the plane or in the airport because we have a layover on the way there, and then the flight back is straight, thank god. So yeah, I'm gonna take you guys with us. We're just gonna be packing for right now, and believe it or not, this is my first wedding with my family from Mexico, and even though I'm half Mexican and it's very much part of me, I have never been to like an authentic Mexican wedding. So this will be very interesting to experience, much more so because my white husband is not Mexican whatsoever. So I've already tried to prepare him and said, hey, it's just you're going to be in for a ride and it's going to be interesting, and we're just gonna have fun. We're gonna enjoy, you know, their union and their marriage, and I'm excited for her. Yeah, I'm interested to see what the whole trip is gonna entail, and I'm also ready for a change of scene because, like I said, it's been very, not muggy, it's been very cloudy here and depressing, and I want some sunshine. So yeah, let's get to packing. Officially packed this bag. This one's so cute. I got it from the Talia store. I'm pretty sure I shared this in my stories, but I'll share it again. I can tag the store below. They're actually only online now, so basically anybody can shop from them.
But yeah, I got my initials done. This is like for the honeymoon initially, but now I just keep using them because it's like super cute and it's huge. I got hair stuff, shower stuff, and all that jazz. And then I used this one. This is a patch that came when I bought like the Summer Fridays Glow body oil, sun body oil. And so this is for skincare. It's that time of the month, so I packed a little bag just for that. And then my curling iron, I put everything in those little like Calpak cubes. Those things are a lifesaver. They seriously make up so much room. In my luggage, I have one hat for the sun so I don't get sunburned or, you know, too tan. One fun fact about me, I hate tanning, so. I'm also taking this massive tote. I'm a firm believer that it's an absolute must to travel with a massive tote because you can literally just throw a bunch of stuff in there. And it's so funny because every time we go through airport security, Jagger's always stressed. And I'm just like, just toss it in! And then he tosses it in here after we're done because everyone's rushing to get to their flight. And he loves it every time I carry this. So, and then I just packed fully just makeup in this bag. I'm probably going to throw in another bag in here because there's just so much room. But I am also taking my laptop for schoolwork. And I'm going to be editing another vlog that's going to go up hopefully this weekend. And then I bought like little wipes to wipe down my seat because I'm just like, I don't want to get sick again. And then a little hand sanitizer. I did not know that Dove made one, but I guess they do. Summer Fridays lip balm, necessary. And yeah, so we're going to put everything in the luggage now. And this is, you know, okay, we are ready. I am wearing my hat because I didn't get to buy one of those little magnetic ones that attach to the bags or the luggage. And I really wanted to be able to do that, but that's okay. We're going to wear it. This is sort of how, or this is a travel hack I was taught on Instagram, what to do when you wear a hat to the airport. And like, clearly I don't need it here because this weather is like, look at that, so gray. So this is my outfit, my airport outfit. Almost always travel in the snowga, and no, I'm not wearing these slippers. I just have white sneakers I need to change into downstairs. But I am wearing this little Target pullover, just a regular white long sleeve tee. In the airplane, I get really cold, honestly. So, yeah, I'm wearing this. This snowga is like a half, like a midi, I don't know what you call this length. I guess just to your shins, but I'm wearing the shorter, not the ankle length ones because it's going to be hot there. So, yep, this is my outfit.
Make sure you...
To Yucatan, specifically the city we're staying in is called Merida. My cousin's getting married here, and she was a bridesmaid in my wedding, and now I'm gonna be a bridesmaid in her wedding. So, I guess I should just give you guys a whole breakdown of everything that happened. We would have and should have been here, basically, like enjoying, you know, the beach and all that stuff from Friday and on. The plan was to be here for 3 full days, one of those days being her wedding. We wanted to be here the day before and the day after, just to sort of situated and relax after the
a whole fiesta, but it didn't work out that way. Basically, what happened was we were on our way to the airport, and we chose to fly out of TJ just because it's, like, most cost-efficient that way, and there's four of us, so we came with my parents. They're upstairs getting ready, but Jagger's making us breakfast. What you making, boo? The house that we're at is, like, not in the middle of nowhere, but it is a little bit further. It's a little bit further away from, like, most of the town, or, like, downtown where all the shops and stuff are. It's like a 20-ish minute or 30-minute drive, which is not bad, but still, we are kind of in a time crunch because I have to be at the hotel where the wedding is at noon, and it's now almost 10 o'clock, so I'm going to have a quick breakfast and then start getting ready and head out. They don't have to be there until later when the wedding starts, but what happened was we were on our way from our house to the airport, and like I said, we were flying out of TJ. This airline we booked our tickets with, basically, like, we were checking in on the way there, and when we were done checking in, it says, oh, your flight for 11:55 p.m. is all set. And we were so confused because we were like, no, we booked a flight for 4:50 p.m. that had a layover, but we were supposed to still arrive there Friday morning / Thursday late night, like around midnight or 1 o'clock. So therefore, we would have had all Friday here. And no, apparently they changed the flight on us, and then we started freaking out, like, did we book the wrong flight? I'm so confused. Like, we know what we paid for, we know what confirmation we got, we didn't make that up. So I got to start searching through my mom's email, because she's like, I'm not tech savvy, so she's even far worse off. And I started searching through her email, and I'm looking, and I'm like, yeah, you definitely have a flight for 4:50. This is the confirmation sent to us via email. Something's up. Like, I don't know what happened. So we start calling them. We're waiting and discussing, and then literally it turns out that last minute they decided to make a change. So now not only did our flight get, like, pushed out with no notice, and it wasn't a quote-unquote delay. That's what's so frustrating, because it's like, okay, if it was a delay, then that happens. But at the very least, they should have sent us a notice or something like, hey, your flight's been delayed, and nothing. So we were kind of frustrated because we were like, dude, okay, whatever. So we're going to leave later. And again, we were driving from our home, which is in Orange County, close to 2 hours away from the San Diego CBX, like, bridge where you just go across to the border at TJ Airport. And we were already driving there as early as, like, I think we left around, like, 12:31. And so... yeah, so we're driving there, and we get all this information, and we're kind of bothered because we're like, are we really supposed to just sit in an airport in TJ for hours until we take off then? So then we're calling, and then here's what gets even harder to sort of swallow and deal with. This new flight that we got pushed out to was not only delayed and taking off way later, it now had this layover in Mexico City for 16 hours. So, listen, the airline doesn't know that we have family there, but we were still like, excuse you, like, how dare you change our flight? We specifically purchased the tickets we purchased because we didn't want a layover. And they were trying to, like, okay, so basically what we can give you is, like, a voucher, we can give you a discount on the next flight, we can give you airline credit, basically. And we're like, that's not you losing anything. Like, you literally don't give us anything. Like, so my mom and I were basically on the phone going back and forth, like, going off on them. I was just like, I'm not accepting anything besides a full refund, or at the very least, give us, like, free tickets to something. Like, I'm not doing this. I don't even know if I ever want to fly with this airline again. And after, like, all of it in the end, it, honestly, we didn't end up getting anything. And I know those types of situations are always so frustrating because I feel like you go to bat for yourself and they respond to you with, like, a half way, so sorry, unfortunately this is our circumstances. And I'm like, how do you not care for good customer service? Yeah, that was our situation, and that's what happened. And so we decided that instead of waiting at TJ Airport, I felt like it was smarter to just go hang out downtown somewhere in San Diego, because we were already near that area. I was like, if we pass San Clemente outlets and whatever, we'll go somewhere else and walk around. I would just rather be there than sit in TJ Airport all day. I'm not doing that. Where we landed was North Park, San Diego, and Jagger was having a hoot because they had this street fair.
I was having a great time.
Street fair food market. So he goes and buys pork buns and I don't even know what else he got. And then I'm like, can you just save me a spot at a coffee shop? Like, I just want to sit down, hash out all my schoolwork, and then maybe at the very least, like, this isn't super unproductive and a total waste of my time. But we landed in Mexico City. There's nothing interesting there to see. We literally just got there at like 4 a.m. We slept, woke up, stayed at my uncle's house for like a few hours until our flight took off, and then headed out, and then now we are here. And we got here late last night. But yeah, luckily we didn't have any baggages or like bags that we had to claim through, like, we didn't check anything and we just brought carry-ons. So yeah, at the end of the day, everyone's safe. And we got here in one piece. I got here before the wedding, which is all that matters. But it is frustrating because now I'm like, I wanted us to have Friday to sort of get situated, figure out what's around, get like some food, you know, stocked up in here. So I had something to eat the morning of the wedding because I basically have to show up dressed and such, and I don't want to go like starved all day up until like the reception. And so the wedding starts at 3. Like I said, it's 10 a.m. right now. We're going to be eating some breakfast. The host, which I'm happy to share where we stayed, by the way, because it actually is a very nice home. And the woman is super... Is it hospitable? Yeah. Okay, the woman is super hospitable. And she's just really sweet. I texted her and I asked her through WhatsApp. And I was like, do you have any recommendations of where we can go? Like a little grocery store or something to just pick up some like croissants or something. Or coffee or croissants. And then she literally came and knocked on the door, brought us eggs, chorizo, tortillas, sugar for our coffee, cream and milk for our coffee. So I was like, you're an angel, an absolute angel. And so yeah, Jagger is now getting to cooking. I'm gonna eat my breakfast and then start getting ready. I have no idea like what I'm doing with my hair. It is, just to give you guys some perspective. Oh, it's only 86 right now, but it is only 10 a.m. Around the time the wedding starts, it's gonna be like 89, 87. And it's muggy, so add the humidity on top of it. I think I'm just gonna do my hair up. I just don't even wanna bother. Jagger was literally trying to tell me last night. He was like, make sure you do your hair down, okay? And I'm like, I'm sorry. Do you have to wear your hair down throughout all that heat? No, sir, this hair's going up. My lovely husband is cooking for our whole family. Look at him. Usually this is something that would land on my mom when she's stressed out with other things. Thank you. eating a banana. I actually had like eggs and ham this morning. My aunt made it for us, and I'm eating this banana now, and I have some coffee. I haven't had my greens yet, but I did wake up kind of late here. For me, guys, I woke up at like noon. Wedding yesterday, oh my gosh, it was so long. I knew it was gonna be ending late because, like I said earlier, this is my family we're talking about, my Mexican family we're talking about, and they tend to go on for a very long time when it's clearly past our bedtime, but our whole family was staying there. And we basically drove over. We're super close to the airport where this Airbnb is, but we're not super close to the actual area where the wedding was, which I guess is not a big deal anymore because it's over, but we're actually going back there today because they're doing like a after wedding brunch with everybody. So like my cousin and her husband now are not actually taking off on their honeymoon this week. I think they're actually not going on their honeymoon until like summer. We got back super late though because it's like my only chance to see my family. And if you guys have been around Hispanic families at all, you know a party can be over, but everyone lingers and hangs out for a long time. And so we didn't really want to take an Uber on our own, driving it back because we were tired, just because it can sometimes not be too safe. And as it is, I had to take an Uber there on my own, and the driver was literally like, "Doesn't it scare you to like travel like this on your own?" And I'm like, "Should I be scared?" I'm so confused right now. I told Jared, he's like, "Oh, like your husband's here. Like, why'd he come with you?" And I was like, "Okay, like I don't know." He just honestly was freaking me out a little bit, but it's fine. It was just so hot. That's really the only thing I can say. Super, super hot. And I was wearing like Spanx and stuff. And so I was just like trying to stay hydrated with as much water as possible. So I had to pee like every stinking. And then I was wearing these like I said, these Spanx just were not quite easy to go to the bathroom, if you know what I mean. So that was fun. You don't want tacos.
Maybe when you get. Ya llevo este empty, mucho espacio en my luggage.
Okay, déjame te doy una little bag.
Okay.
Va a ser, no así, pero una chiquita como esta, te voy a... Just like, describe it in 3 words. And be nice.
Way too loud.
It's definitely music all night long, I will say. Alright, I gotta get ready. I showed you guys in some clips sort of what the setup was for her. It was very boho. Chic, I think, is what she wanted, and it came out perfect, I would say.
Tres, dos, uno, listo.
You gonna have a picture?
Yeah, at this rate.
He'll do it, yeah. ¿Ya tienes un minuto? Nah.
¿Por qué?
Dice, no me distraigas. Ay. No sé dónde se fue. Estos niños quieren su dinero. ¿Y Jagger dice, ¿se cuenta con eso? Ok.
Son business.
Yeah, they are.
Ellos
están buscando a dónde. Ahora sí, minuto y 30. Uh-oh. Yes! Ah! With a 1 minute left! Gotcha. Yeah?
Eventually.
So good.
Or day, whatever day it may be. And I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye!